Hello, everyone, all who are one body of Christ. Our Savior welcomes you to this day that has given us together. Today, we will be meditating upon, are we celebrating Christmas season outward or inward in our souls and our spirits? Before we start, let's see what Scripture talks about this topic. Luke chapter 1, verse 46 to 55. And Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in my God, my Savior. For he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and his holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those who have humble estate. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his offspring forever. Now let's see what we can learn from the verse we just read. When Mary received the good news that Holy Spirit will overshadow her and she will conceive a baby, she was probably shocked and terrified of what will happen and how people will respond. According to the culture and law of Moses, she could have been removed and stoned to death. But instead of worrying about all those possible problems, she began to worship the Lord. She broke out into powerful response of praise, worship, and heartfelt adoration. I have often wondered if when declaring these words of praise, she fell to her knees and lifted her hands toward heaven. She exclaimed, my Lord will be done for me. She exclaimed to me, all that my Lord wanted will happen. Their response was repeated when she visited her cousin, who was also pregnant. There Mary responded in adoration of the Lord. My soul exalts the Lord. This simple exclamatory sentence were the first words out of Mary's mouth in Elizabeth's presence. Mary's choice of words are especially beautiful when one realizes that soul is the birthplace of passion, emotions, aversions, and desires. Mary's soul was not in a state of confusion or denial. She was declaring the fact that regardless of circumstances or events, her emotions and desires would always take her to a place of worship. The second part of her exclamation was, my spirit has rejoiced in my Savior. Mary's soul and her spirit were joining in a beautiful duet of thanksgiving. One spirit is the place in the human constitution that desires the Lord all that he has. The spirit is the place of walking by faith and not by sight. In this place of Mary's life, that was in a constant communion with the Spirit of God. And the response was the same, sincere rejoicing. How are we responding to circumstances or events that we don't understand or perhaps might not choose? What is our soul spending time doing this Christmas season? Is our soul out of control with spending, eating, and impatience? Or has our soul observed the example of how Mary has chosen to exalt the Lord? What matters most to us is this Christmas season is to observe ourselves and see what we are celebrating, a festival of our extraordinary gift when we have received 2,000 plus years ago from our Lord. A couple of days ago, I was a part of a Christmas carol and met with a homeowner who was putting lights on his bushes outside his house. His house looks so beautiful with the lights spread across and seems really beautiful. We extended ourselves and asked him, do you like to sing some carols for you? And his response was, no, thanks, I'm good. Are we responding to our Lord with eternal joy or just externally to show how good we are? Let's examine ourselves and see what exactly the meaning of the message of the good news is. Let's pray for ourselves and for all others to know the Lord's will for our lives and through the Holy Spirit, rejoice in him and respond to his calling with faith regardless of our circumstances, regardless of people will say. Let's be a part of his plan this Christmas, adoring this child in our lives, not just by exclaiming but the true receiving him as our Savior. Rejoice in him by repeating, my soul exalts in the Lord and my spirit has rejoiced in my God, my Savior. My spirit is our and our souls will fall on our knees and will lift our hands and our voice towards heaven. We'll proclaim the glory of God who was and is to come. Celebrate the birth of Christ, our Savior, inside and outside of us. Let's celebrate this Christmas in a different way, this year and the years to come. This message also gives a promise for you today. The promise is, and I will give you a new heart and a new spirit I will put within you. And I will remove the heart of stone from your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit within you, because you will walk into my statutes and be careful to obey my rules. You shall dwell in the land that I gave to your fathers, and you shall be my people, and I shall be your God. And I will deliver you from all your uncleanness, and I will summon the grain and make it abundant and lay up no famine upon you. I will make the fruit of the tree and increase the field abundantly, that you may never again suffer the disgrace of famine among the nations. Let's close time in prayer together. Please join me in this prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, mighty wonderful God, Lord, thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for the wonderful gift of salvation I have received through your grace upon me. Thank you once again for having the Holy Spirit lead me to understand that the celebration of the season should not end with the season, because seasons come and go. But Lord, your presence will take new birth inside me, my soul, and I will be renewed now and forevermore. In Jesus' holy name I pray, amen. Have a blessed day and enjoy the birth of Christ, not just outside, but inside.